Hello everybody, 6-Speed Dakota here. In today's project, we're going to be replacing wheel bearings in the bay liner. Not repacking, but replacing, because they're all loose and worn out and, well, just generally garbage. So, tools you're going to need. You need some punches, small hammer, and a good array of pliers, vice grips. You may need screwdrivers. You may need a big socket, something to take the wheels off with, and I highly recommend an air compressor and a blow gun. So, some parts you're going to need. Well, I've already gotten the one side apart, but brake parts cleaner, I highly recommend. And you're obviously going to need bearings, inner and outer, and then the races to go with them. These bearings, usually the bearings come as a set with the race inside, but this guy here does not. So, I have to order the races separately. I'm still waiting for parts, but for now we can get started. Also, you're going to need a couple of these cotter pins to lock the hub back in place again. So, well, if you can see her right there, there's the bay liner. So let's get started. Alright, I also recommend wearing a pair of these nitrile gloves. So, first step, remove the wheel. There we go. Okay, next step, take your small screwdriver and your hammer. Pop your dust cap off. Damn, grease mark on the driveway. So now, to find where the nut is, I'm gonna wipe all the grease off. There we go. A lot of paper towel ready. This is a messy job. Now, as you can see, there's this stupid pin right here. Now you're gonna have to bend out one end and drive it through. So this took me about 20 minutes the last time, so I'm gonna just film me getting it out, because, you know, it's not really a fun job. But as you can see here, this thing's pretty mangled, so we got a couple proper cotter pins to replace this stupid thing with. Okay, so I got most of it out. All I gotta do is just center punch this stupid thing out of here. Come off it. This one only took me 5 minutes. There's that stupid thing right there. Okay, next step. And take this nut off. Oh, Jesus, this thing's really on there. There we go. Okay, now we're going to pull the hub and bearing assembly out. Just be careful, I found some wicked spiders in there last year, so don't know what's in store this year. Hopefully nothing, there's nothing in the other side. So, pull it out just a little bit and push it back in, that'll slide the bearing out. Thrust washer right here. Now all that's left to do is pull the hub off. And I don't see any creepy crawlies in there this year. Got lucky. Alright. Okay, so now it's time to dry the seal out. So we're looking at the hub from the top side here. And there's the bearing in there. Now you're going to want to hit this. Oh, there we go. This outer surface right here that I'm pointing to. This inner surface, sorry. That's hardened steel. If you hit the cage, which is that inner bit there, you're going to damage the bearing. Not that it really matters because we're replacing the bearings, but that's just how you do it. Okay, so now using our breaking parts cleaner, we're going to clean up the inside of this guy. Make sure you do this in a well-ventilated area. Stuff smells pretty nasty. Okay, so before we begin the next step, we have to make sure that it's absolutely clean inside there, because if it's not, when you go to drive the race out with your drift punch, if it skips by accident at all, you could actually start a fire with a spark caused from it. I've seen it happen. I've seen the spark happen. I haven't seen a fire yet, though. So what we're going to do is we're going to go and hit it on the back side of this lip here. You can see way down in there that little lip. And this piece here is the hardened steel race. And they don't look too bad, but from my eye, I don't know if you can see with the camera, there's a bit of heavy scoring on there. So bearings develop a wear pattern with respect to their races. So what you have to make sure you replace the races every time that you replace the bearings. So all you need is a drift punch and a hammer and a little bit of aggression. So slam your hand on the door a couple times and go to town. But not too bad, because if you mar the machine surface up, then you might have to take it to a machine shop and get them to repair it. So don't go too overboard. The trick is, what you want to do is one corner, two corner, three corner, four corner. Do your four corners and it should come out with no troubles. And that was the pleasing sound of the race coming out. Now if you look right there on the inside here, that's the smooth machine surface, or at least it should be smooth. And that's what... Now if it's pitted at all, make sure you clean it up a little bit, and if you have to, you might have to go get it repaired at a machine shop. So, same thing with the other side. But this time what I recommend is actually putting it in the tire to keep it up off the floor. So I'm going to do that, and we'll be back after I get that race out. Alright, now to install the new races, you get our safety glasses. Because this is hardened steel, always wear your safety glasses. And drift punch and hammer. So what you can do is you can take the old race and use it as a punch. Busting right through the cloth. Now you don't want to use any lubrication here or the race could start actually spinning inside the hub. Drift punch. We're going to be extremely careful. A couple light taps. A couple taps on all four corners. And what we're going to try not to do is we're going to try not to scratch that race inside there. So, take your time and work it all the way down. Okay, so when you get the race all the way down to the bottom, you're going to hear more of a harmonic-y kind of ting. So just a sound demonstration, and you'll definitely know when it's down there. You'll feel it. You can actually hear the drum have that ting, ting, ting noise. That means you're all the way down. So now all you have to do is flip this bad boy over and install the other race. And then we're ready to move on to the next step. Okay, now it's time to pack the bearings. So you're going to want to use a good grease, a premium grease. Okay. Notice how this grease is red grease and it's sticky. It's not very runny. Some of the green greases are very runny. And that's bad because, especially the biodegradable ones, that's very bad because what happens when you stick your boat in the water is it'll dissolve the grease inside the hub. So use a good sticky grease like this. So just want to take a little bit of grease and you're going to wipe it around. The race is like this. Clean these races off with some brake cleaner before you put them in, because they do come with an anti-rust coating, like a sticky coating, kind of like brake rotors do as well. So on both races, the one in there, deep in there as well, put grease on. Then take a very thick dollop of grease and smear it into the hub so that it levels out these races, as you can see what I mean, so that it's level with the both race surfaces. And then we're going to move on to packing the bearings. Now it's time to pack the bearings. Now in this case, in case you haven't watched my other video, I'm going to do it anyway on how to repack wheel bearings. So what you're going to do is you're going to take your dominant hand. So I'm right-handed, so I'm going to take my right hand, take a dollop of grease. You put the grease in the palm of your undominant hand, or in this case, my left hand. Then, I'm going to open the new bearing that I forgot to open earlier. Nope. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to hold the bearing like this, with the wide opening facing towards me, put two fingers through it, and hold on to it and prevent that cage from spinning. Nope. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the grease. Now, I don't know if you can see this real well. I don't have as good a viewpoint on this one. So I'm actually pulling the bearing through the grease like this. Now, if I continue to do it, what you're going to start to see is the grease actually protruding through the bearing. And that's what you want. Now, you want to do that all the way around. And if you're not absolutely sure that thing's completely packed, it doesn't hurt to go around one more time. So I'm going to pack all these bearings and we're going to move on to installing the seals. Okay, I got all the bearings packed. Now what we're going to do is we want to wipe some grease kind of in and around this bearing. This is supposed to prevent the grease from melting out and flowing out of here. I don't know if it's true or not, but that's the way I've been taught. Do the same to this hub. Just like that. Okay. There we go. Just clean all the grease out. Then we're going to put the seal right there. And then with a hammer, just going to lightly tap it in until it's seated flush with the hub. I got to do this with two hands, so. Just got to be careful not to damage the seal while you're putting it in. Tap only along the corners of it until the seal is perfectly flush with the hub. Then you know it's installed correctly. So what you do is take a bit of grease and you wipe a little bit of grease in this inside lip. Now it's time to go install it on the trailer. Alright, now we're going to do a little due diligence while we're in here. So, we're going to take a long screwdriver. We're going to pry back on each of the brake shoes here. We're going to lubricate each of these friction points. There's three on either side, or on either shoe. We're going to lubricate them with anti-seize. So, pry back. Paint a little bit on there. There's one here. There's one here. And there's one at the bottom on each shoe. And while we're at it, we're going to take a little bit of grease, we're going to smear it all over the spindle, the points where the bearings ride, which is the front and the back, and then this little lip here, which is what the seal rides on. That'll prevent the seal from blowing out. Also, open this boot up and make sure that there's no leakage going on, or you're going to have to replace that. Another thing you should always do is give the star adjuster, which is right here, a thorough coat of anti-seize. This is not an automatic adjusting brake, but this will prevent that star adjuster from getting stuck, from being dunked in the water, in the salt water all the time. So apply a liberal amount to that. And on to the next step. Okay, so now we're going to put the hub back on. So, first step is bring the hub up. Get it in there. Take your wheel bearing. Push it on up in there. Spin the hub a couple times to push that seal onto the shaft. And do the grease wiping thing again on the outer bearing. Then, take the thrust washer. Be sure that it's clean. And then, I'm going to lubricate both sides of it, just with a little bit of grease. Put it on there. And then we're going to take our castellated lock nut. Start cleaning it off a little bit, and we're going to install that next. Okay, clean this dude off. I'm going to put the castle lock nut on. And run it all the way down. A bit of a stiff spot. Brakes a little tight, but we'll fix that in a second. So what we're going to do is we're going to spin the hub in a clockwise direction while we tighten this nut. Now you don't want to, oops, there we go. You want to tighten it really firmly, but just snug it down. There we go. And that'll set up the bearings inside there. Now we're going to back it off half a turn. We're going to spin the hub, once again, in a clockwise direction. Tighten this nut as hard as we can while it's hand tight. And it should, like it does here, line up straight across. So, I'm supposed to install the cotter pin. That thing's a little tight, so I might need to give it a little bit of love. Okay, so we'll just keep, now that I've sort of gotten it through. These pins come in no set length, so they're always really long. Helps if you have a pair of pliers there at your disposal. And drive it till that loop sits right in the groove of that lock nut. Then, grab your pair of side cutters, bend this dude up, and over, and then trim the end so that you can get access to that grease fitting. Okay, my side cutters suck. There we go. Make sure that's bent out so that it's not going to cause this thing to back off. So that holds that nut firmly in place, and that's exactly what it's designed to do. So be sure to pay special attention to this step, because this step is extremely important, setting the preload and then locking it down with this cotter pin. There we go. So notice how that cotter pin can't slide out. It's just the way it should be. Alright, now the final step is to install this dust cap. All you have to do is just give it a couple of love taps. There's a piece of dirt in there, oops. And there we go. Firmly. Now, you take these rubber guys, do not brake clean these. Oh, there we go. Or they will dry out. This guy's actually expanded a bit. There we go. And that's all there is to it. Now just throw the wheel on and take it for a test tow. Alright. Now, there we go, there's the light. Be sure to pay special attention to the part where you set the preload, because this is very, very important. If you mess this up, you will end up with a wheel bearing failure. So if you're not competent, don't do this job. Alright, thanks for comments, thanks for watching, and if you have anything else that you want to request for me to do, just feel free to drop me a line, drop me a comment, and that's no problem. Thanks for watching, everybody.